in an accident, a 4x4 is much more likely to kill a child than an ordinary car. This is how my daughter was left when she was hit by one. 6 months in hospital, lucky to be alive. If that's not enough, they pump out huge volumes of greenhouse gases. Think of that before you buy one.
You finished? You don't want to chain the door shut?
Yeah.
Oh, you got a key? Go on in, lads.
I'm dreadfully sorry about this, man. Like I said, I could throw in a year's insurance. And your first service. And floor mats, of course. What the hell are you doing? I don't make the rules. I just sell cars.
Well, you're selling weapons of mass destruction.
Can you both calm down?
You're ruining my business.
Will you ruin my daughter's life?
Right, so I'm arresting you for a threatening behaviour and assault.
Oh, you don't have to handcuff me.
I'll tell you what, behave, and I might take him off. Right, Beth, caution her. Put her in the car. Speak to the victim. You all right?
You're a bit young, isn't she? Haven't I seen you at my daughter's school?
You do not have to say anything, but it may harm your defence if you do not mention my girlfriend.
It's the second time this month. She won't leave me alone.
Why?
Her daughter. The 4x4 that knocked her down. I sold it.
Well, what's that got to do with you?
Precisely. She thinks like I'm some sort of arms dealer, like I'm responsible. I feel bad for her. I've got kids. I know what it's like. I lost a sale because of her this morning. First one this week. And look at that. Any idea how long it's going to take me to get that off?
It's criminal damage. Do you want to make a complaint?
I just want her to stay away.
I mean, driving a tank round London, it's just selfish. Surely you can see that.
Well...
clearly not.
Look, can you just wait here a sec? You all right?
Yeah, I checked her out on the criminal, like you said. She's got previous for breach of the peace and criminal damage, all eco-related over the past 6 months, but nothing before.
Well, it's probably her daughter's accident that set her off. OK, now, keep spate. I don't want to pursue this, so we don't need to push it. But we can leave her in a cell while we do the paperwork. Let her know we mean business.
Where are you going now?
To work. I've got a whole food cafe on the high street.
Oh, I know the one. Great music.
You're free to go. But if we have to deal with you again, we won't be so understanding. Come on. Got to get back out on patrol.
So how long have you been friends with Will?
I don't know, about a year. Why?
Just wondered. What?
Nothing.
I warn you, Dan, don't let my height fool you. If I hear any rumours going around that station, then you can forget about having children.
Yeah, my lips are sealed. Here you are, this must be them.
Oh, you lot, come over here.
Why aren't you lot at school?
It's lunchtime, we're allowed out.
What's your name?
Claire Smith.
The shop owner, don't want you lot hanging around.
Do I look like a shoplifter to you? All right, then. Search me if you must, but, officer, be gentle.
All right, that's enough. You lot get back to school.
Are you going to take down my particulars?
Do one. Make a note of her name. If she truants again, we'll nick her.
Was that your stomach?
Yeah. Didn't have any breakfast. I'm gonna get a greasy burger, you want one?
Mm, no thanks.
All units, disturbance at Rachel's Cafe. 351 the High Street. Informant is the owner, Mrs. Rachel Sterling. Any unit deal?
Rachel, what now?
Sierra Oscar from Sierra Oscar 2-1, show us a sign.
He smashed a window.
Who?
Well, who do you think?
Where'd a telly come from?
Well, the skip outside. This will cost me hundreds, and I don't have insurance.
But what happened?
Mr. Spate came round an hour ago. He was furious. His face was bright red. He started shouting, threatening me.
Well, what did he say?
That if I didn't stop the protest, he'd ruin me. After he left, I went to hand out some leaflets outside the shopping centre. When I came back, it was like this.
How long were you gone for?
About an hour.
Mum, don't touch anything.
You have to arrest him. What if someone had been in the cafe?
Look, there's some fibres caught on the corner.
All right. Forensics would be interested in that.
Heath's bike left about an hour ago. No one knows where he is, and he's not on Tony's mobile.
Right, he'll turn up and come back later.
315 from Sierra Oscar.
Go ahead.
We've got a Keith Spake at the front desk. He wants to speak to you.
Received. Come on, Beth.
Right, what do you want to talk about?
I've changed my mind. I want to press charges against Rachel Sterling.
Why?
Well, the softly-softly approach isn't working, is it?
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Spate. Now that Rachel's been released, you can't go back on your decision to take no action. In fact, we wouldn't mind asking you a few questions about the incident at Rachel's caf today.
What kind of incident? No. No, I don't want to get involved.
Right, then. You're under arrest for criminal damage. Do not have to say anything, but it may harm your defence if you do not mention when questioned something which you later rely on in court. Anything you do say may be given in evidence.
What's all this about?
Well, someone put an old TV through a window in Rachel's caf.
Well, you think I did it?
Where were you at 2 p.m. this afternoon? You went to see her, didn't you?
Yes, but only to make a final appeal to her. I left her around 1:30.
Then where'd you go?
I had a meeting with the regional manager.
Right. Mr. Spate, if you did break that window, your prints would be all over that TV. Now, if you've got something to hide, you better come clean now. We do realise you've been under some pressure recently.
Well, I don't have anything to hide.
Well, I suggest you give us a number to your regional manager, then.
Are you going to speak to him?
What's your problem? He's your alibi.
I'd just rather you didn't.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Spate, but we do need to investigate the criminal damage done to Rachel's calf.
Yeah, we'll need to take your fingerprints, too.
Then you'll be bailed pending further inquiries.
This is ridiculous. I'm the victim here. That woman attacked me. And now you're pinning this on me.
Dad?
Yeah?
Keith Spate lied to us. I've just got off the phone to his regional manager. He did have that meeting today, but it was before we went round to Rachel's to give that final warning. His manager's hopping mad about the protest. Told Spate to sort it or to find another job.
Oh, nice. Right, let's go pick him up then.
Yeah, I also did an FIU check. It's a bit weird. It seems he bought two cars from his own dealership in the past month.
Well, he's desperate. He wants the business to look healthy. What do you reckon?
I think he's a nice guy under a lot of pressure, so got frustrated and lashed out. I do feel sorry for Keith, but Rachel's right, isn't she? RTAs involving 4x4s are normally a lot worse, aren't they?
I think it's unlicensed cabs that cause all the trouble. And cyclists. I mean, he'd be stupid enough to ride a bike in London. You lied to us about the time of your meeting, didn't you, Mr. Spate? You finished way before you said it would, so you had time to get to Rachel's calf.
Look, Rachel Sterling does my head in. I admit it. There's nothing I'd like more than to take a sledgehammer to a calf. I couldn't do it. Ask anyone. I haven't got the guts. I'm too soft. Too soft to sell cars, that's for sure.
What do you mean?
I've quit, OK? You can tell Rachel's mad, but at least she stood up for herself. That's what my manager said. So I told him to stick it.
Good. Look, excuse me. Hello?
The forensics have been in from Rachel's calf. They've lifted some prints from the telly, but none of them match Keith's weight.
Well, they're still claiming he's innocent, yeah?
Yeah, they looked at the threads we found. Nothing odd, just green cotton. Did Rachel say anything to you about touching the telly?
No, nothing.
Right, well, it says here that her prints are all over it.
Right, cheeky man, she's trying to set him up. OK, I'll come back to the station. Meet me outside. We'll go and have a word with her.
Have you charged him?
We haven't got any evidence to say Mr. Spate did it, but he did ask me to let you know he's quit his job. Rachel, did you touch the TV at any point after you found it?
Why'd you ask?
Because your fingerprints are all over it.
Well, I found the telly lying in the street this morning. I put it in the skip.
We found some green cotton fibres on the side, and this morning you were wearing a green top.
Wool. A woolen top, not cotton. Really? If you think I'd smash my own shop up, you're wrong. This is my daughter coming back from school. This is Rose.
Not Claire Smith.
What's going on?
I spoke to your daughter today at lunchtime. She wanted school.
What? Rose, is this true?
I had a free period.
Well, you know you're not allowed off the school grounds, even in a free period.
Oh, come on. Don't try and play the Kerry mother act just because the police are here.
I don't suppose you could tell us anything about a smashed window, could you, Rose?
Well, now, just hang on. What are you saying?
Well, the threads we found are the same colour as Rose's uniform.
Yeah, how'd you rip your sleeve?
Rose? I did it. I smashed the window. And he enjoyed it.
Then we'll have to arrest you for criminal damage.
Why, Rose? After all I've done. For you. For both of us. I love you. And you just
no,
gotta...
you don't.
What?
You don't love me. That girl on the poster, lying in the hospital bed, tubes down her throat. You love her.
But you're the poster girl for an important cause.
I'm Rose. I'm not a victim. All I want is to have a bit of fun. Is that so much to ask?
That woman almost took everything from me. You were lying there in a coma. They told me you might die. I never told you. But at one point, your heart stopped beating. And I watched them trying to resuscitate you. I promised that if you lived,
I... What about me, Mum? Today, we're supposed to go to hospital for my checkup. Together.
I forgot.
Can we assume you won't be prosecuted?
Yeah. I think we just need a bit of time.